Good morning. Another lovely morning it is too. We're now walking out of Hoathwaite National Trust campsite, having wished we hadn't paid because no one came and checked that we were even here. But there we are, we like giving away 45 quid. The team are perky, they've all had a good night's kit, and even Dave.
Dave, yeah, come on. Come
You're on. Happy, aren't you, Dave?
Yeah, honestly.
So, the lovely Claire has been with us and taken all our gear, which was soaked. So the trouble with the sun, the tent's cool, and during the night, lots of condensation. But look at that, we're off. This time it's 9 miles, and we're heading for Little Loughrigg Tarn, Little Langdow, Three Shires Pub, etc., etc. And our campsite is Tarn Foot Farm. How you feeling, guys?
We're so happy.
Yes, camping wasn't that great because it was very, very cold. Everyone was freezing, and in the morning, the tops of boxes actually had thick ice on. So, unfortunately, with a clear sky comes the problems of that.
Oh dear.
Yeah, it's been great fun with this lot, I can tell you.
Day 2 of our adventure along the 74-mile Cumbria Way takes us from Hoathwaite campsite in Torver, through Coniston and Tarn Howes, via the excellent Colwith Force to Loughrigg Tarn and our campsite on Tarn Foot Farm. This leg, on paper, was down as 9 miles on the route card and map, but due to several visits to the bar and toilets at the Black Bull in Coniston, a bimble around Tarn Howes, and having to double back when I had forgotten to visit Colwith Force, we ended up recording 12 and a half miles. The weather was once again fantastic, and the coldness of last night in the tents was soon forgotten, to a certain degree. So the sun was out and the beer was on tap. There's only one word to say: enjoy. Though the first night's camp at Hoathwaite wasn't greeted with much enthusiasm, when we walked down to Coniston and saw how beautiful it was and yet another fantastic day, spirits were soon lifted. Of course, our enthusiasm to crack on was with the knowledge of knowing that Coniston was bringing with it the prospect of our first beer stop of the trip. And boy, did we look forward to it. After a very pleasant hour and a half, having beer and a couple of pasties, we set off into open countryside, and now we were looking forward to seeing Tarn House in all its glory in this beautiful weather.
Lovely. Smashing. Good stroll.
Beautiful day.
Yep. Lovely stroll.
I knew I shouldn't have had them 16 pies and then 4 beers.
Believe me when I tell you, I've got a frog in my throat when I look back and think about how beautiful the Lake District looked that day. I truly love this place. Well, here we are. Tarn House. First time I've really seen it on a glorious day. Been here several times, never on a cracking day like this. You can probably hear a little bit of wind, but to be honest, it's nothing. We're 5 and a little bit miles in. We're just enjoying a nice break, and very nice it is too. Just 3.5 to go, or roughly 3 3/4. But I think we're going to spend a bit of time here. It's rather pleasant. First time Bert's seen it, so he's lapping it. Totally wheelchair accessible, so everyone can have a look at it. Beatrix Potter's paradise. As we took our final look back at the Coniston Fells, it was with awe, truly magnificent. However, we were keen to get to our next hidden gem of the lakes, Colwith Force. Just a shame I was so caught up in the scenery I forgot to check the map, and we had to double back a little bit here to get to the place. As impressive as that was, legs were now starting to get a bit weary, especially as we were doing well over the mileage we had originally planned. So we were now keen to get to Tarn Foot Farm, meet the lovely Claire in the support vehicle, and have another lovely night under canvas in glorious warmth and comfort. After meeting up with Claire and bidding her farewell until the next morning, we set up camp on a beautiful summer's evening with glorious scenery. However, the mood was somber, not because we only had the farm butler sink and a cold tap for washing, but because Rob's knee was so painful, he could not put any weight on it at all and could barely walk to his tent. So we didn't go to the Three Shires pub that night as planned and just went to bed early in hope that Rob's knee would feel better in the morning. Sadly, if not, a big decision was going to have to be made. Thank you for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed it and found it informative. Make sure you look out for the other six in the series, showing all the legs all the way to Carlisle. Please check out the other videos on our YouTube website, all 214 Wainwrights captured in video, as well as the outlying fells and various other walks. As always, hopefully one day, we'll see you out there. Thanks for watching. Cheers.